status.
Okay, thank you.
Labour Principal Secretary Ismail Ali and his Foreign Affairs counterpart Karanja Kibicho were before the National Assembly's Labour Committee over increased publicity of job opportunities in Jordan, as well as progress in formalizing labour exportation to the Middle East.
This particular point in time, as a ministry, we do not have any official information regarding job opportunities in Jordan.
With the help of Parliament and executive order, we need to create actually a law that supports us in stopping some cadre of workers.
The two members of the cabinet extended their message of caution to Kenyans seeking domestic job opportunities in the Arabian countries. The Foreign Affairs Ministry confirmed the government was still in the process of developing a policy to get labor export to the Middle East.
Kenyans are suffering in the Gulf countries. Has been in existence for several years now. How come 4 years, 5 years down the line, apparently we are still suffering the same lethargy? Nothing has happened.
Despite all this push to dissuade, they go, they don't report to the mission, nobody knows where they are. We only come to know that they're in problems when they, because there are very many Kenyans, we don't know where they are because they haven't reported.
Committee members were, however, concerned with the executive's delay to forward proposed laws that would address the suffering faced by Kenyans working in the Middle East. The Labour Ministry also came under fire after revealing it lacked data on Kenyans who are working in the diaspora.
The agencies seem to be having a field day in this country. You know, I was very surprised that when we were traveling, despite the fact that some of them were actually on tax force, they're on business, chairman. On their, it's embarrassing. We have gone on taxpayers' money. We are there. They are transacting. They are communicating with the other. It doesn't add up, honestly.
We still have some of these agencies. I know that the government is closing in on them. Every time we know where they are arrested, but they still continue to recruit.
The government imposed a ban on recruitment of laborers for export 6 months ago, but Labor Committee members are still concerned that recruitment agencies are still operating. Kevin Washira, Channel One News.